So back in the day, when I was a kid in school and scribbling little flipnote animations into my school books, which was very forbidden and I felt very badass doing it, I thought, if 2D animations can be done so easily, how aren't, like, 3D animations a thing? I was a simple kid, don't judge me, okay? Like, not a 3D movie, but in real life, like a Star Wars hologram or something. Later in life, I learned that there's a thing called Zoetrope and that you can also make 3D Zoetropes, which are probably the closest things to holograms that you can make at home by yourself. I know there's cool hologram stuff out there, but we're on low budget here, right? But let's get the basics right first. For a regular Zoetrope, you need a 2D animation like this beautiful panicking blob, for example. Then you have to print out the frames of that animation. Between the frames, you need to cut slits to see through, and then put them together in a circle facing inwards. And if you spin this thing and look through the slits from the side, you'll see the animation. Pretty cool, just not enough
dimensions.
To make a 3D one, we first need an object or character to animate. In this case, I just made a little smiley cube to keep things simple. I modeled and animated it in Blender, which is free and cool, and you can do so many things with that, man. And then split the animation in 20 separate stages, just like 3D frames. Put supports on them, because in real life, they tend to not float. Then you just print all this stuff out, and a little 3D print fun tip trick fact. When you print several figurines, you can select sequential printing in your slicing software, which makes the printer make them one by one instead of all at the same time. Just makes the quality better and reduces stringing. We do not want stringing. Here you can see me assembling all the stuff and may notice the little numbers on the bottoms of the models, which helped me to not confuse them. Also knock them over all the time. Like, why did it film it like that? So now I needed a motor to spin the whole thing. I tried it with a small computer fan I had laying around. And as you can see, when making a 3D Zoetrope, you usually don't use a wall with slits in it like the 2D one, but a stroboscope that only makes the models visible for a short moment, which makes it look like the individual models are animated but staying in the same place. In this case, I just used the smartphone stroboscope app because, again, we are on low budget. Anyway, I had problems to achieve that effect with this fan because it was always speeding up or slowing down instead of maintaining a certain speed. So I had to look for another solution and found this big fan and an outlet voltage controller. Even though the problem with maintaining speed still occurred, this one was spinning a lot faster, making the animation visible. Look at that. To finish this project, I wanted it to run at a steady and controlled speed. So I used a 360 servo, which is just a motor that spins like every other. Why is it called servo to begin with anyway? I used this and an Arduino to control it. To balance the weight difference of the models on the disc, I taped some nuts onto it. Well, this is the final result of the video. Every camera freaked out a little, and I guess it's because I used the smartphone app for the stroboscope. So I also cheated a little bit and put some clean footage into this. Hope you enjoy this. See you next time. Hopefully. Come, please come back, okay? All right, thanks, ciao.